Did you always dream about making an own cartoon, but you thought it's too time-consuming and complicated? Do you have an own YouTube channel, or are you producing video content for customers? Do you want to make your content more individual and more outstanding than others?
Good! Then you should watch this video until the end, and you will learn how to make your own cool cartoon character. These days, there are millions of content creators out there, and especially if you're just starting with producing your own videos, it can feel like impossible to make your own video clips outstanding from the others. But here comes one solution. If you would be able to create a unique cartoon style that is easier and quicker than alternative animation techniques, you should keep watching.
Wow, you are taking it serious! I will subscribe to this channel and activate the bell.
Let's not waste time and start! Hello and welcome to this very exciting cartoon character animation tutorial. This is Argos Eyes Cinema, and today we are going to create this wonderful cartoon character. First of all, we are starting to create a cartoon character in Photoshop. I would recommend a composition size with a width and height of 3000 pixels. Even if the final video resolution will be lower in the end, a bigger character size allows us to do close-ups without a loss of resolution. Before you are starting, think about how your character should look like. For this tutorial, I chose the actress and creative model Nabiha Lecoq as reference. If you are interested in her work, you can visit her on her social media pages. You will find the links under this video. But let's give her a second to introduce herself.
Hey guys, I'm Nabiha and I hope you really like the following video. I'm a French actress and model located in Paris. If you want to learn more about me, you can check out my Instagram page. I'm not that hard to find. It's going to be linked somewhere below anyway. And if you want to chat about acting, writing, philosophy, anything really, come on up. See ya.
After choosing a good photo, I'm adjusting its size until the head has the size the final cartoon character should have. Of course, you don't need a photo, but for characters with a real reference, it makes the process much easier. I'm starting with creating a single layer and a group folder. For a better overview, the group folder should be named after the character. Then I'm creating another group and name it Head. Now I'm moving the head group under the main group and the layer in the head group. Now I'm moving the photo to the top and select the eyedropper tool to get a sample of her skin tone. I'm reducing the opacity of the photo so that we are able to see what we are drawing through it. After selecting the layer, I'm tracing the shape of her head with a pen tool. Now I'm creating a new layer and name it Plus Nose. The plus in the name is important so that later Adobe Character Animator will recognize it as an independent layer. After choosing a color that is a bit darker than the skin tone, I'm selecting the pen tool again and draw a rough shape for the nose. Now I'm turning the filling for the pen off and select the darker skin tone under Stroke. Then I adjust the thickness of the line. You can always change the opacity of the photo so that you are able to see what you are working on. After the shape of the nose is defined, I'm using the eraser tool to make the edges of the nose line a bit smoother. Now I'm creating a new layer in a new group folder and name it Mouth. After choosing a suitable color, I'm drawing the shape of the mouth with a pen tool. Time for the eyes. I rasterize the background layer and draw the shape of the right eye with a pen tool. Usually cartoon characters have much bigger eyes, so I'm pressing Ctrl plus T to scale the eye a bit. Then I select the pen tool again, click with the right mouse button in the eye, click on Make Selection and OK. With the active selection, I click on the background layer and press Delete. Now we have a hole in the background layer. For the left eye, I'm following exactly the same procedure. When we are switching the photo off, we can see what we have. The next step are the hair. Again, I'm drawing a rough shape with a pen tool. Nabiha has black hair, but for now I'm using a dark gray instead of pure black. Later I will use pure black for the shadows. While this hair layer was placed on top of the other layers, I'm creating a second hair layer below them. This layer is for the hair in the background. To keep the overview, I named the first layer Hair Foreground and the other one Hair Background. Back to the eyes. As you know, we only have holes in the background layer where the eyes should be. To create the eyes, I'm starting with a new layer in a new group, named Right Eye. I'm picking a very bright gray as color, pick the ellipse tool and draw an eyeball. I'm naming the layer, surprise, right eyeball. Then I'm choosing a very dark brown and draw the pupil. Now I'm drawing two small white ellipses in the pupil to represent light reflections. Then I'm drawing a black ellipse between the brown and the white ellipses. I select all the ellipses, press the right mouse button and click on Merge Layers. I name the merged layer plus right pupil, again plus, so that Adobe Character Animator recognizes the pupil as independent layer. This way, we will be able to move the pupil separately. For the left eye, I just copy the right eye's group and move it in place. With Ctrl plus T, I'm switching to the transformation mode and scale the left eye a bit down, as it is slightly further away than the right eye. To fill the black gaps, I'm creating a rough shape in the same color like the eyeballs behind them.
Why didn't you draw the eyeballs bigger instead?
Adobe Character Animator is using the eyeballs as a frame within the pupils are movable. If I would make the eyeballs bigger, the pupils would move out of the visible part of the eyes and disappear behind the background layer. I want to avoid this. Now I'm doing the eyelids. I'm creating a new layer in the right eye group and name it plus right eyelid top plus because it should be able to move later. I'm using the reference photo to get an idea how the shape of the eyelid could look like and create it with a pen tool and the same skin tone like the background layer. I'm also adding a bit makeup. I'm creating another layer and name it plus right eyelid bottom and draw the eyelid shape with a pen tool. Before I'm creating the left eyelids, I rename the previously copied layers to plus left pupil and left eyeball. Then I create the top left and the bottom left eyelids. Don't forget to name them plus left eyelid top and plus left eyelid bottom. Now I'm going to add the eyebrows, naming them plus right eyebrow and plus left eyebrow, because I want to enable them to do face expressions. I draw them with a pen tool. The basic shapes are done, but I want to add some more details like the feather earrings she's wearing on the photo. I draw one earring with a pen tool and just duplicate the layer to get the other earring. Again, I'm naming them plus right earring and plus left earring, because they should be able to move later. I'm picking the color of the lips with the eyedropper tool, making it a bit darker and trace the shape of the mouth with a pen tool. Now it's time for the neck. I'm doing it the same way like the other shapes of the face. Now, as we have the basic shapes of the face, it's time for my favorite part, the shading. I select the background layer and create a new layer above it. I'm making it a clipping mask by pressing Alt and clicking just between the new layer and the background layer. When I'm drawing on the clipping mask layer, only the area of the background layer will be affected by the color. For the shades, I'm using pure black, select the brush tool and choose the soft round pressure opacity and flow brush. I draw over the face where the shadows are meant to be by using my graphic tablet. Check the links in the video description if you are interested in what graphic tablet I'm using. I repeat the same steps to draw the shadows of all the other parts of the face, nose, eyelids, mouth and neck. Let's add some details to the hair. I use the pen tool to create some strands of hair above the original hair layer. I name every strand of hair plus hair because I want to add some independent organic movement to them at a later point. Now I'm doing the shading of the hair like I did for the other parts of her face before. I create a clipping mask for every single layer and draw the shadows above. Once the shadows are done, I'm doing some highlights by selecting white as color, choosing the soft round pressure opacity and flow brush and draw them on the clipping masks. This looks already much better. I'm happy with the head, time for the body. I'm creating a new subfolder naming it body. Inside the body folder I'm starting by creating a new layer called torso. To get a symmetrical shape, I'm creating only one half of the torso, duplicate the layer, go on Edit, Transform Path and flip horizontal. Then I move everything in position and merge the two torso parts to one layer. I transform the body size by pressing Ctrl and T until I'm happy with the result. Next, I colorize the torso blue using the Paint Bucket tool. For the décolleté, I'm creating a clipping mask above the torso layer and create a shape in her skin color. Now I create a new layer for the hips. For the hips and the legs, I'm using a dark gray color. For each leg, I'm creating an own folder with one layer for the leg and one layer for the shoe. I'm naming the first leg folder plus right leg because it should be able to move later. Then I duplicate the folder, name it plus left leg, flip it horizontally and move it in position. Now I create a new layer and a new folder for the right arm. I name the folder plus right arm. Then I create the arm with a pen tool before I create a new layer for creating the hand. As I did it with the legs, I just duplicate the arm folder, name the duplicate plus left arm, flip it horizontally and move it in position. Time for the shading and setting some highlights. Like I did it with the head, I create a clipping mask for every single layer of the body and draw the shades and the highlights by using the soft round pressure opacity and flow brush. Let's jump to the exciting part. I imported the character to Adobe Character Animator to take a first look on what we have so far. By moving my face in front of the webcam, the face tracker of Adobe Character Animator detects my expressions and transfers them automatically to the character. As you can see, for now it's only working for the eyes and the whole puppet is moving when I move my face. But we are going to fix this now. I click on Rig on the top left corner. In the rigging mode, you are able to see all the different layers we just created in Photoshop. So let's start to set up all the body parts that should be able to move independently. I start with the left arm by selecting the left arm group and move the anchor point to the spot where the shoulder should be. With the selected anchor point, I'm clicking on the left shoulder of the puppet preview on the right side. Now the program is able to identify the function of the shoulder. As next step, I'm selecting the dragger tool on the bottom of the screen and click on the hand. When I switch to record, I'm able to move the arm with the mouse cursor. At the current state, the arm is stretchy and doesn't look really good, but we will fix this soon. Back in rigging mode, I'm selecting the dragger icon on the left hand and click on left wrist on the puppet preview. Then I select the handle tool and click on left elbow in the puppet preview. Afterwards, I select the stick tool and draw some bones by clicking and holding the left mouse button. I'm doing the same for the right arm. To improve the arm movement, I click on the character's name on the top, click the plus icon next to behaviors and select arm IK. Back in recording mode, you can already see the difference. The arms are not able to stretch anymore and the movement looks much more realistic. To avoid that the character is floating around in the scene, I select the torso layer, draw a stick over the hips and click on fixed. Now, only the body part above the hips is moving when I move in front of the webcam. If you remember, I told you that I want to animate the hair. So back in rigging mode, I select the first strand of hair, move the anchor point to the top and click on the dangle tool and place the dangle on the bottom. I'm doing this with every strand of hair. Back in recording mode, you can adjust the physics to simulate wind or a change of the gravity, but the hair will also move slightly if you are moving the head around. Let's start with the character. If I select the character, the puppet track behavior menu appears on the right side of the screen. You will see a red spot next to the behavior if the behavior is activated. I can control the head and the eyelashes with my own head movement via webcam and the arms with my mouse cursor. To make a recording, I simply click on the recording button and move the character with my head movement and the mouse cursor. Press the recording button or space if you are done with the movement. After I'm done with the right arm, I'm pressing the recording button again and repeat it with the left arm. This is enough information for this video. You learned how to create and animate your first cartoon character. If you want to learn how to create and animate the mouth, you should watch my Adobe Character Animator mouth animation tutorial. Now a little preview how it will look like.
Hi, I'm Nabiya. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please visit me on my Instagram account via the link below. Bye!
Thank you for watching. If you like my videos and you want to support Nabiya Lecoq and me, or you should be interested in working with exactly this cartoon puppet, you can buy the Photoshop file in my Gumroad store. With the voucher code Nabiha Lecoq, you are getting it for 20% off. You will find the link to the Nabiha Lecoq cartoon puppet in the description under this video. You are allowed to use the puppet for any kind of cartoon projects. It doesn't matter if you want to use it in your own cartoon or if you want to print her on a shirt or sell the shirt on Spreadshirt, Redbubble or Shopify. You are supporting us and maybe you can even make money with it.
Wow! This was so informative! You learned how to create a proper cartoon character! See you next time!
Bye bye!